Well, a great scoring team. Maybe they were most affected, Dan, by their eye for the net, because that was apparent tonight. Anderson, how many chances did he miss tonight? Gretzky missed opportunities. Again, don't take anything away from Billy Smith and the Islanders, because they were superb. But again, I think the Oilers, perhaps in the next game, will be a little bit better at the sharp shooting department than they were tonight.
And the Islanders, remember, did this without Mike Bossy, their big scorer. We talked a lot about Billy Smith, another guy that played his heart out both ends of the rink. Bryan, Trottier, the great center iceman with the Islanders. He's down in our USA studio with Al Trautwig.
Well, Dan Kelly, the key word for number 19 of the Islanders is fatigue. It is a very tired Bryan Trottier that sits next to me, but I'm sure the elation of winning game one supersedes those feelings of fatigue.
Isn't that the truth, boy? There's nothing like a victory to take away all the hurts and sores. They're a great hockey team. They stormed us all night long. They have nothing to be embarrassed about. We were holding on, and believe me, that's exactly what we're doing. Smitty made some great saves. They missed some great opportunities. Right towards the end there, Bobby Nye walks in on a breakaway, and you look at the chance maybe Tinelli might have had. But you just can't say enough about our defensemen. They were tipping pucks, deflecting pucks, just clearing pucks out from in front of the net, and Smitty was making the big save. Bang, we'd get the rebound off into the corner. And I tell you, I don't want to play any more like this. I'd rather be up two or three goals rather than those one goal leads there.
Your work rate tonight was amazing. I mean, you were in every play that you were on the ice, at both ends of the ice.
It just seemed like the puck was in our end most of the night. And there's sometimes where, you know, I'm a little bit tired, but Al wants me out there for the draw, so I'll stay out there. And it ends up like, if they end up keeping the puck in there, it just goes out over our blue line and right back in our zone. I can't get off the ice, so I end up staying out there longer than really I want to, Al wants to. Because it takes away from the flow of the line changes a little bit, and we don't like that. I'd rather get right off the ice and keep everybody going.
Bryan, coming into this series, you knew that you would have to slow down this fast-skating Edmonton Oiler offense. And while they had their opportunities, certainly you and Billy Smith and the entire Islander team knows that, they were also able to shut down the Islander offense. It never seemed to get going. Why did that happen?
I don't know. I'm just happy.
It's a good question, isn't it?
I'm just happy it worked out that way. There's a lot of reasons. I mean, to stop and think right offhand, you can't think of any. I mean, defensively, you can't even start.
In the game, there were so many chances for the Edmonton Oilers to score. In the last minute, they had a period's worth of chances. Did you see frustration on their faces? Did they seem to be losing it at all in any part of the game, or did their overriding confidence just prevail throughout the game?
Well, I don't know. You know, there was a couple chances in front of the net, you know, where they're so smooth and they're so smart with the puck, where it looked like they were jumping on it a little bit, you know, and that happens a little bit. You know, you're anxious, you're eager, and you're over-ready sometimes. You jump on a little sooner than you should have, rather than take your time. And there's other times where if you would have jumped on it rather than taking your time, you might have. So you don't know. You know, those are things that during the game, you know, you reflect and you say, well, now I'm going to learn from that. And believe me, they're going to be a lot smarter hockey team next game. And I tell you, it's going to be tough.
This is the second time in the playoffs that the Islanders have received bad news the day of a game. At least it was the day of the game as far as everyone here was concerned. It was first you in the early series when everyone said, oh, Bryan Trottier is not going to play. And all of a sudden, the Islanders responded with a fantastic game. They really played their hearts out. And tonight, I think we saw very much the same thing as Mike Bossy was not able to play.
Well, Mike more or less is a big reason why we're here in the finals. You know, it was his effort in the last game against Boston. I mean, four goals. You know, that was enough of an incentive for the players to go out there and work their hearts out for him. He's dying to play. He didn't want to sit out. But we need him strong and healthy for this series, and we don't want one game tonight to, wear him out for the rest of the series. You know, it was a smart move by management, and, they've been around a long time. They see how things work, and, the guys were able to come up with a great effort tonight. It worked out in our favor, and hopefully Mike will be back in the lineup on Thursday.
Well, it was hot in that arena tonight, and a cold shower is going to feel good. Our Stanley Cup star tonight for Bryan Trottier of the New York Islanders, 2-0 winners. Thanks very much, Bryan.
Al, I'd just like to say hello to my family back home in New York if they're watching.
I'm sure they are. For being our Stanley Cup star, Bryan Trottier will receive a quartz analog watch by Timex, the MVP in watches. Timex believes that precision timekeeping and great design are not expensive, just rare. Timex, we make technology beautiful. And from Norelco, this close-shaving Norelco Rototract razor. It shaves you as close as a blade without the nicks and cuts. The Rototract razor, tough on your beard, not on your face. It trims mustaches, and it's from Norelco. As an added gift, here's Ice Hockey by Activision, one of the hardest-hitting, toughest video games for your Atari 2600. Congratulations to Bryan Trottier, and if you want to make it official, you can say hi to who's watching now.
Nikki, Bryan Jr., Monty, and Lindsay, if she's still up. I think she's sleeping.
All right, it's time to go to bed. It's been a long night for the Islanders and for the Oilers as well, a frustrating night for them. But the Islanders prevail with a convincing defensive performance by the score of 2-0. That's the story from Edmonton. Tonight's game.